Yeah, I would like to talk about sailing. As you know, my favorite summer sport, my favorite winter sport is skiing. So my favorite summer sport is sailing. But sailing is different for me. Yeah, I started skiing when I was a small kid, and actually I was skiing my whole life. However, I grew up in Moscow, and the sea is very far away from Moscow. There's no sea. The first time I actually saw sea when I came to the United States. So sailing is different for me. That's something that I learned after I came to this country. And I came to Rhode Island, and if you live in Rhode Island, there's no way that you can avoid sea, ocean. Yeah, ocean is just there. So I decided to take advantage of that, and I took sailing lessons at the University of Rhode Island Sailing Club. And it was a lot of fun. we were sailing on a small boat. These boats are designed for one or two person, typically one person, and there's about 12 feet long, about from the wall up to here. And those sailing boats, they have only one or two sails. Big main sail and one additional smaller sail, it's called the jib. Yeah, and that boat is designed for one or two people. Yeah, the interesting thing about those sailing boats that actually that they can flip if you do handle them well. it's called to capsize. Yeah. So actually they flip over, and after that you actually swim, and you need to put them back. That's how it works. And of course you have the saber jackets on you. That's a must. All right, and I took the sailing lessons, and I liked it so much that I decided to take the intermediate sailing lessons after that, and I like sailing very much. And during each summer, I went sailing maybe four or five times during the season. I would like to tell you one story that's happened, one of the adventures, one of my sailing adventures that happened with me. Yeah, to share that interesting story with you. And the story goes that a friend of mine, he bought a catamaran. Catamaran it's a sail. It's the difference between catamaran and a sailboat that catamaran actually has two bodies, two hulls, and it has one big mainsail. It has a jib in front. And the good thing about catamarans that catamarans, unlike sailing boats, can travel really fast. So we decided to try out his catamaran. So we came to the marina, to the waterfront, unloaded the catamaran, put the catamaran into the water, and we start sailing. And it was on the 4th of July. It was a long, nice weekend. The sun was good. The weather was beautiful. The wind was copious. And we start sailing, and we were sailing downwind in Narragansett Bay, and we were sailing really fast. Because the waves were pretty choppy, and we were just flying there. My friend Dave, he was sitting at the stern, and he was steering the boat. I was sitting at the front of the boat. I was handling the jib, the front sail. Also, my job was actually to hike out of the boat. Because the catamarans actually, when it goes, it actually tilted. So you need to hang outside to try to keep it flat. And it was moving really fast. And you know, water spray was going on us. It was really beautiful. At some point, we dive the hull of the catamaran dive into the wave, because the waves are pretty big. The hull of the catamaran dived into the wave, and there's a big wave that went on top of the catamaran. When I turned back to look at Dave, for what I found, that Dave is not there, but Dave is like 50 yards back, and he's in the water. And catamaran keeps traveling by the same speed, moving fast, and I'm still hiking over there. And the steering. And it starts slowly turning against the wind, actually. And I start actually climbing to the back of the boat. But I was too late. It's the catamaran starts turning sharply. And what Dave told me, it was what I did. I was thrown, and it's flipped. So I was thrown into the air, And Dave told me it was pretty spectacular. Actually, I made a salt out of that before it landed into the water. And after that, I start actually getting, try to get, when I got to the surface of the water, I saw that the catamaran actually is moving. He was already on the side. One of the hulls was underneath the water. The other one, the other hull was above the water. And the sail of the catamaran was flat on the water, but it was drifting away. So, and I spent the next 5 or 10 minutes just to trying to catch up with that catamaran. And Dave actually joined me 10 minutes after that. The next, maybe 30 or 1 hour, we just spent in the water trying to put the whole thing back. And what I found, it's very exhaustive when you are kind of nervous, you're panicking, you're in the water, you try, also you actually have clothes on you, but you have the sailor jacket on you. But still, you spend so much energy, it was very exhaustive. And we were trying to put the whole thing back. And I think we put it once, but after that, we flipped to the other side. So it was pretty long time when we managed to straighten up the catamaran. Other people on the motorboats, was a couple of people on the motorboats came to us, asked if we need any help. I said, no, don't need help. So eventually we put the catamaran back flat to the water, we climbed on it, we had some rest. But that wasn't the end of the adventure, actually. Because at this point, we decided that we need to go back. And before that, we were sailing downwind, which is nice and easy. Now, we needed to sail upwind. And typically, what you do, you sail in zigzags and making 90-degree turns upwind. It's called tacking. Okay. And we tried to do it. And actually, Dave, he tried to do it, and he couldn't manage to tack it. Just couldn't complete the maneuver. And what he told me, you know what, and he asked me, what am I doing wrong? I said, I don't know. It's your catamaran, you should know. I said, no, you took sailing lessons, you should know. So from my perspective, I never sailed catamarans, and they handled differently from sailboats. So I assume that Dave knows what we are supposed to do and how to handle catamarans. Dave, on his part, thought that I know how to sail catamarans because I took the lessons. So, and after that, we tried to figure out how to actually complete that maneuver, and it was pretty hard. And we spent the rest of the afternoon actually doing it until we reached the marina. And by the time, actually, one of the hulls, it was the boat started kind of leaking, and one of the hulls was heavy. It was very difficult to handle the boat. And actually, when the catamaran was flipped, we lost a windex that shows the direction of the wind. One of the main sail was a little bit damaged. Dave, he lost his car keys, we lost our water supply, so we spent the whole afternoon on the heat without any water. So when at the evening when we came back to marina, we didn't have the car keys. So, and after that we spent additional 2 or 3 hours, as I can remember, trying to get the keys and put the whole thing on his trailer. And it was a long, the whole day, very long adventure. So that's was one of the most extreme adventures that I have on the water. But overall, most of my experience with sailing were really pleasant, and I would like to continue sailing. So my plan for the summer is maybe to find a sailing club somewhere in Baltimore and resume it.